Okay, we are done. Starting from part A to part D, in solving this complex problem, that is separation of a protein by affinity chromatography, we are going to separate two proteins, A and B, which having two different capacity factors, say 0.85 for A and 1.05 for B, and the HTP and liquid velocity are related by the van Diemter equation, and we solved A, B, C, D in the previous four videos. So it's just a recap, and this video has something important to show. So what is the minimum HTP which we got? So it's just a recap. So we solved by plotting this to establish the relationship between H and U, and for part B we got the minimum HTP value. H minimum is equal to 1.665 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter, and we got this HTP at U is equal to 0.365 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter per second. And will A and B be separated in the large column? That is the part C. So we said yes, it can be separated. We solved it and we got the value of resolution. R is equal to 1.5913, which is greater than 1.5. So A and B can be separated. Right? So the part D is, if you use a smaller column, what is the maximum Q that will give the complete separation? So we started solving using the criteria, resolution should be greater than 1.5, and we arrived at the Q maximum, and we reported the value in liter per minute, that is 0.19 liter per minute. So Q max liter per minute. So I was about to show you the plot between the H and U, right, starting from 0.1 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter per second to 2 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter per second. So this is a recap of the values that we got from the previous video on the plot. This pending, right? So we will see in this video. Okay, I have plotted the relationship between U, that is liquid flow, that is liquid velocity in meter per second. Along x-axis, you can see U in meter per second, scale 10 raised to the power negative 4 scale, and H in meter, which is the height equivalent to theoretical plate, which has a scale of 10 into 10 raised to the power negative 4, that is say 0.5 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 scale, and here 0.5 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 scale. So this is the plot generated by the van Diemter, that is H is equal to A by U plus B U plus C. You can see a beautiful curve. See, from here to here, that is say at this point, I have plotted this using MS Excel. You can check out the value here. It shows 0.3 at liquid velocity, 0.3 till 0.3. The height equivalent to theoretical plate was very high. And as we go, say from 0.4 to 2, it increases. So HTP decreases at low, say it comes from high value to low value, it reaches a minimum value between 0.3 and 0.4. You can see the value of x, say 0.4 into, and the y value 1.67 into 10 raised to the power negative 4. And in the previous point, 0.3 into 10 raised to the power negative 4, that is a liquid velocity, and corresponding y value 1.69 into 10 raised to the power negative 4. So between these two points, there is the minimum HTP, which could be around 1.66 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter. Okay, remember this value, 1.66 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter. And the corresponding x, the liquid flow velocity, should be between 0.3 and 0.4 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter per second, right? This is a plot. Okay, I have shown the plot to you. Okay, coming back. So while showing the plot, I said that the HTTP minimum is 1.66 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter, which is in agreement with the value that we calculated in part B by differentiating the Van Diemter equation with respect to u and equating the slope to 0. On the velocity, say the optimal velocity which gives this minimum HTTP lies between 0.3 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter per second and 0.4 into 10 raised to the power negative 4 meter per second. Yeah, so this is the value which we found by differentiating. So 0.365 into 10 raised to the power negative 4, which is between 0.3 and 0.4. Thank you.